Is it courage or madness that draws him back? Past and present collide as John Stanley returns to the Fisherman's Wharf Wax Museum and the Chamber of Horrors. Stanley's past catches up to him. Jack the Ripper awakens to violently confront Stanley. Is it revenge that Jack wants? Is it something else? Find out for yourself as the horrors of yesterday unfold before your very eyes. See, The Mummy Rises. Explore the haunted mine of lost souls. Experience Nightmare in the Chamber of Horrors. Then, feel the terror as the demon strikes back. In Meeting at Morningside, John Stanley is violently abducted and taken for a wild ride through a graveyard. Meet Angus Scrim and Don Coscarelli of Phantasm. Join Stanley at the San Francisco Zoo, where he is caged and tormented by Lee Grant and Carol Kane.
So what the fans are going to see in these mini-movies tonight is the early original Chuck Norris, part of his career that's kind of been forgotten.
Yeah, you took the fall for Chuck.
And how?
Okay.
Thrilling martial arts action explodes onto the screen with John Stanley as the Channel 2 Dragon. But wait! Two more hours of adventure and horror lurk on disc number 2.
About all those private eyes we were talking about, I remember you did a takeoff on them, and they really killed them.
That was called Private Eye Night, yeah.
Yeah, you did a mini movie called Little Shop of Murders.
Not out in 15 minutes, you're to call the cops. Get me?
Chandler. He wrote with a real hard, two-fisted style.
Oh! Hey, you're hard-hitting yourself. You know, I had fun spoofing all of that crime literature, and it all started when I did a takeoff on Sir Arthur Conan Doyle's Sherlock Holmes.
I knew there was something elementary about you, Stanley.
Tonight, a mystery in the finest tradition of Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, the creator of Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson of Baker Street.
Play it, Carlos. Play it.
McCormick.
John, how are you?
What are you doing on? This is not Dialing for Dollars.
I know, it's true, though. I heard you were doing a private eye thing. I love private
eyes. You like private eyes?
I love private eyes.
Well, look. Great. Look, why don't you take over the show for a few minutes? Here's the gun. It's Snubnose 38. You got to have that. And here's the booze. This is rot gut like you've never had in your life. Now, you need something else, Pat, not an Alka-Seltzer.
Oh,
but you gotta have a beautiful blonde if you're a private eye. Gloria,
that's
come
right,
on over
sweetheart.
Here.
I gotta have a... Oh. Oh, hi.
Don't get your valves in an uproar. I picked up the pieces, did a little surgery, and edited everything back together.
Oh, great. You know, you had me in stitches there for just a moment.
Gargantua, you've been living with me now for about a week, and I just want you fans to know that there's only one thing wrong with living with a gorilla. You can't potty train him.
Now I'm trying to bring back a certain mini-movie. At a scarecrow contest in Vacaville, you brought back a private eye theme.
Yeah, it was a two-parter called Attack of the Incredible Killer Scarecrow.
There an angry god of scarecrows named Xenomorphia, who comes to Earth every 100 years to wreak revenge on mankind? Personable Creature Features host John Stanley thinks so, and has hired a look-alike to protect him during the Nut Tree's Great Scarecrow Contest. But the double is suddenly viciously murdered. Private Investigator Don Heron is totally baffled.
Two discs. 4 hours of thrills. Available now at stanleybooks.net.